And yes, here we are live again. And I think it's working. I see the screen and I hope my sound is working as well. So welcome for the ones that already are waiting for this live workout. And as always, we just wait a few more minutes for everyone to join because they will get a mention when I click on live and they will get ready. Today's workout is going to be a full body cardio toning, and that's literally full body. We're going to do arms, abs, legs, a little bit of the back. So everyone, every muscle is involved in this workout. And if you have grabbed some light weights, I just use 1 kilogram dumbbells, not that heavy, just a little extra weight in the exercises because it's full body cardio. And of course, we want to get that heart rate up. So we're speeding up during the exercises. And with a heavy weight, that's not possible. So make sure the weights are not that heavy and a little bit light. Your towel and, of course, a water bottle, filled one, of course. That's all you need in this workout. And if you don't have any weights, you can perform this workout body weight only. No problem at all. And let's see, Sue is joining later today. Just enjoy your coffee and then rewind this workout because after the live workout, it's direct available as a normal workout. So everyone who doesn't join right on time on this time, you can join later. But Gina is here and RM from Newcastle, England is also here. So at least in the chat, I see there are more people joined this workout. So we're just waiting a few more seconds, minutes, and then we're starting. So I hope you're all in a good mood for this workout. Because it's going to be intense, of course, full body. And let's see what time it is. It's exactly 4 p.m. here in the Netherlands. So let's say we're just waiting one more minute to the people to join. And if you just joined, we're going to do full body today. If you have some, use some light weights. We're starting with a short warm-up. Then we do 2 rounds of 10 minutes, 5 exercises in the first round, repeat it twice. Then we have a break. We do 5 new exercises in round number 2. And of course, we finish with a cool down and a bit of stretching at the end of this workout. So let's see. I'm going to start my timer. And that means we still have 1 minute before we're starting the workout with the warm-up. So I'm going to press play. And now you have 1 minute to get ready. And yes, Terry is ready for the workout. And another one with a nickname. Greetings back from the Netherlands. And Gertrude, you're also ready. Yes. Glad you're all here joining this workout today live with me. It's the second one of the Revive Your Fitness program. Not sure if you're all following the program, but I hope you like it. The 4 workouts every week. So let's see. 20 seconds till we're starting the warm-up. And you don't need your weights during the warm-up. We pick them up when we go over to the main exercises. In that warm-up, we just need that blood flow going, that heart rate up a little bit, and prepare ourselves, prepare our bodies to the main workout. So here we go. In 2 seconds, we're starting with a march out and in. And alternating, starting left and right. So you just march in and out. Time to get some steps in. Getting the heart rate up a little bit. Marching out and in. And never go too fast in the warm-up. First of all, warm up, and then you can speed up in the main workout. So just keep on marching out and in, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left. A few more. Then we're going to warm up the calves, of course, because we're going to do a lot of steps. Cardio full body today. using some light weights if you have those final steps. And then what we're going to do is a step. We raise up on our toes, stepping out, stepping out. And when we raise, we swing, pulse, swing, hop. So you make a side step, go down a little bit, then raise on your toes and make that swing, hop. Warming up the calves, the quads, and making a swing, getting that blood in the arms as well. So just step down, raise up on your toes. Raise up on your toes, that's it. Come on, make yourself long and swing. Find your balance already. Up and swing. We do a few more, and then we stick to the arms, making sure the shoulders are warm, because we're going to need it, holding those weights. Up, come on, raise up your toes. One more, and then standing still. Okay, few arm swings, front and back. Really opening up, squeezing the shoulder blades together when you swing back. Slightly bend your knees. You can add a little bounce if you want. Keep on swinging. A few more, and then we're going to do some circles, making sure the shoulders are warm. Okay, over to the circles, to the front. Big ones. Add that pulse if you want. And we're going to reverse those circles. All right. Now, so reverse, backward circles, big ones. Over and over, just a few more. And going back to the lower body with some hip openers. Right. Now, okay. Knee up and open to the outside. Getting the step in. That's it. Upper body straight up. And focus really on opening the hips. So keep your hips still and then circling that knee to the outside. Up. Because we're going to do some wide stance steps, some wide squat pulses in the main workout. So make sure your hips are warmed up, opened up. That's it. And don't go too fast. Make sure your heart rate is up a little bit. We're going to do one final exercise in a warm-up. And we're drinking some water, getting the body hydrated before you're starting the main workout. So come on, final hip openers, knee up to the outside. And that's it. Over to a wide stand. Toes are loin pointing a little bit to the outside, upper body straight up. And we're going to pulse from side to side. And when you pulse, make sure you press that knee out. Again, opening the hips, stretching up a little bit, and warming up the quads and glutes. Singles, right and left, right and left, making a pulse. Up, side to side, and then go a little bit deeper for a more intense stretch. Stay here, feeling that quad burn. And over to the other side. Press the knee out. Open up. Stay down, feeling that stretch on the inner thigh. And we're finishing with a few singles. Side to side. Pulsing it up. And that's it. Okay, come on all the way up. Shake out your legs. And then prepare yourself for the main workout. So hydrate your body, take a sip of water. And then grab your dumbbells, if you have them ready. For the ones who joined in a little bit later, I just used 1 kilogram of dumbbells, light ones, just a little bit extra in this workout. If you don't have them, no worries, you can perform this workout without it. The first exercise you can do is an easy one. We hold the weights on chest height. We're stepping out and then just pressing the weights in front, making a little bit of twist in with the upper body using our core. So make sure you engage your abs. And then after that, we're going to bring the weights together, making a swing up, swing down, swing up, swing down. So we're going to up and down pulses with the legs, But I will explain. First exercise started in 3 seconds. So come on. Weights are on chest height. Bend your arms. And here we go. So we're stepping out, pressing that weight in front. Come on. Twist in that upper body just a little bit. Keep the hips still. Chest up. And we've started the main workout. So come on. Speed it up a little bit. It's time to get a heart rate up and have a great full body cardio toning workout today. We do every exercise 50 seconds on. We have 10 seconds active rest in between the exercises, so you know that. Come on. Press it out, but do not overstretch. Twist in a little bit. Come on, tuck that belly in and engage. 5 more seconds. Come on, step it out. Final one. That's it. Okay, stay active, but try to re-catch your breath a little bit in between the exercises. Bring the weights together. You're going to step out and swing. So come on, swinging down, up, and coming up, and down, and up. So you make a double swing, staying down, coming up. When you're down, make sure you press the knees out and squeezing the glutes, working that lower body and the arms in the same time. Tuck your belly in. So keep on swinging those arms up and down to keep that heart rate up, and up, and down, and up. That's it. Come on. Just a few more seconds. Keep on swinging. Bring the weights up on chest height. Press it out and up. Swing it. And one more down. Final ones up. That's it. Okay, the next one, another one for the shoulders, but now we're going to press up instead of pressing front, and we're tapping side to side. So weights slightly above the shoulders, tap it out and press. Hop. You don't have to do a step to the side and then come back, just tap it, tap it, tap it, and press the weights up above your head. Make that tap to the side as far as you can, slightly bend the knees, and keep your upper body straight up. While pressing above your head, make sure you don't have a hollow back. So tuck the belly in and press it. Come on. Tap it, left hand right, and press it out. Keep on pressing. 10 more seconds. Up. Side to side. Alternating. Final ones. And that's it. Okay, the next one is starting with the arms to the side, making a squat, bringing the weights together, then opening up and stepping out to the other side. So arms up, squat, and open up. Squat, and open up. Up. And with this one, you don't have to do a deep squat, just enough to keep that heart rate up and feel that in the quads and glutes. Up. Keep the shoulders down low, chest up, step it out. Working the shoulders, the chest, the outer thighs, the quads, the glutes, all in one move. Come on, 15 seconds. Keep the arms up, keep stepping out. That's it. Come on, almost there. Up, and the last one, lower the weights down. Final exercise of the first round, then we're repeating. Going to do high knees, and we're chopping down, making crunches. So both weights together above your head. Hop, knee up, and bring the weights down. Hop, up. Really crunch it. So bring that knee to the outside a little bit, so you can chop the weights down without hitting your knee. Up. Come all the way up, and make sure you squeeze your abs, really hammer down with power. Up, come on. Working those abs while keeping the heart rate up. Up, down, down with power. That's it, 10 seconds. Bring your weights up, down, down. Almost there. Last one, that's it. Okay, halfway in the round. So going back to that side step with the front press. Weights up and go. Come on, you can do this. Step it out and press. Press. That's it. Keep the weights up on chest height. Press it out and really twist in a little bit with that upper body. Engaging your abs, working your core here as well. Hop. Come on, twist in a little. Tap it out. Press the weights in front. Yes. Keep going. Come on, press it. Left, right, 15 seconds. Up, side to side. Keep the weights up. Come on. Don't lower down. Keep pressing out. Twist it. Final one. And that's it. Okay, take a deep breath in. The next one is that swing down, swing up. So bring the weights up and down. Here we go. Go down, up and up. Swing and down. Swing and up. Make sure you tuck that belly in. Come on. Slightly keep the arms bent. Up. And when you're down, press the heels into the floor, the knees out. Squeeze the glutes. That's it. Up, swing. And up. And down. And try to go real down with the down swings. That's it. Challenging the quads and the glutes. 10 more seconds. Come on, keep on swinging. Up. And up. And down. Final one up. And that's it. Okay. The next one is that jack press. So we're going to press for the shoulders, making taps. Weights up and go. Tap it. Tap it. So slightly keep the knees bent. Tap to the side as far as you can. We want to keep that heart rate up and press the weights up. Come on, working those shoulders. Tuck that belly in. Never ignore your core. Up and press it. When you press up, do not overstretch. Make sure you keep your arms slightly bent and tap it. That's it. Up, right and left, right and left. 15 seconds. Keep pressing up. Up. Don't slow down. Keep up that pace. Great. Up. Final ones. That's it. Lower the weights down. Two more exercises and then water break already. We're going over to that squat with the openers. You don't have to do a deep squat. Come on, weights up, squat it down, bring the weights together. Make sure your shoulders are down low, your chest is up, up. Come on, step it out from side to side. A little bounce in the legs and keep the weights up. I know this one's heavy, it's going to burn in the arms, but just ignore it, keep the arms up, and keep stepping. You're almost at the end of round number one. Up. Come on, keep it up. 15 seconds. I know you can do this. Step it out, open up, keep going. Up. Final five, step it out, one more. And then lower it down. We finish with the high knees, chopping it down. Really crunch it, use your abs. Weights together above your head and go. High knee, chop it down. Hop, up. And make sure you bring that knee a little bit to the outside. Hop, hop. Otherwise, we have blue knees at the end of this workout, full of bruises. We don't want that. Come on. Hammer down with power. Crunch it. Crunch it. Come on. Give all you've got left in this first round. 20 seconds. Up. And crunch. Crunch it down. That's it. Final ones. Don't quit. Keep going. Up. Last one. And that's it. Well done. Drop those weights And right, catch your breath a little bit. Get rid of your sweat if you want. And most important, drink some water. Hydrate your body. Take some rest. Right, catch your breath a little. Before we go over to round number two, we do 5 new exercises. And let me see. Lisa's also here. Welcome, Lisa and Kat. And Charles, welcome. So focus on your breathing. Take a deep breath in and out. And another one. In and out. Really lowering that heart rate down because we need to get ready for round number two. And it's going to be the same intensity. Or maybe if you have something left, you can speed up during the end of the workout. Choose it. In just 50 seconds, we're starting again. So make sure you're ready. Drink some water. And now I have to stop because I really want to save something for the end of this workout. I think I could drink a gallon of water right now, but I will do that later. So make sure you have your weights ready again in half a minute. We're starting with round number two. The first exercise we're going to do is a crest step behind and we're making a half a circle with the arms up and down. Working our lats or shoulders. And then the next exercise is a side lunge. We're stepping out, making an upright row, stepping out to the other side. But I will explain. Get ready, have your weight ready. 5 seconds. Starting with that cross step, half circle, palms are facing front. Here we go again. So come on, cross step and make that half a circle up. So bend your arms and just bring the weights up above your head while cross-stepping behind, up, that's it. One hand up, the other one's down. Make sure you tuck your belly in because you don't want a hollow back. Up, cross behind. It's asking a little bit of the balance coordination, but I know you've got this. Come on, circle up, up, that's it. 10 more seconds, bring the weights up and down. Guide them up, guide them down. Do not drop it. Up, up and down. One more, and that's it. So that second one is that side lunge and that upright row. Elbows going out and bring the weights up on chest height. So there we go. Stepping out left and bring up. Right, up, up. Make sure you press the knee out, lowering that butt. Working lower body and shoulders here all together. So step out and row, row. Come on, going from side to side. That's it. Just make that side lunge. If you can't go too deep, just step it out. Always choose your option. Up. 10 more seconds. Come on, row up. Elbows to the outside. That's it. Up. Shoulders down, chest up. One more. That's it. Lower it down. The next one is a standing still exercise. What we're going to do is swinging up and then bending over. Come on up. Follow me. Bend over. Alternating swings. And over. Up. And over. It's a great exercise for the back of your shoulders and a little bit of your lower back. Up, but keep on swinging. And when you bend over, make sure your knees are slightly bent. Up, bend over, come up. Keep on swinging the weights, alternating. That's it. Make big movements. Your arms are slightly bent, wrists are in a straight line. When you bend over, make sure your back is straight and tuck that belly in. 10 more seconds. Come on, working the backside off your shoulders, upper part of your back. One more up, and that's it, lower it down. The next one is a lunge, we curl and we press. Then alternating to the other side. So we're going to a little bit more in the corner. And here we go. Lunge, curl, press up, curl, press up, curl, press up. That's it. Make that lunge, make that bicep curl, and then press up. That's it. Up, curl, press up. Side to side. Make sure you lower that knee to right above the floor. Up. Come on. Up. Up. Press it out. Curl. Working biceps, shoulders, glutes. All in one move. 10 more seconds. Come on. Curl. Press out. Curl. Press out. One more. Let's finish with that press. That's it. And the final exercise of round number two, of course, we're going to repeat. It's a reverse step with a row. Arms are going up, and every time you tap back, you row. Up, up. That's it. So make sure you row, bring that weight towards your waistline, squeezing the shoulder blade together. Tap it back. Up. Keeping the weights up. Real burner again. Keep that heart rate up. And row. Elbows small against your body. And when you tap back, up, row back, squeeze that shoulder blade together. That's it. Come on, 15 seconds. You can do this. Keeping the weights up, keep rowing. Row, row, final 5 seconds. That's it. Last one. That's it. Drop the weights down. Break at your breath a little. And we're going over for round number two, second round. Going to do that cross step with half circles. There we go. Come on. Up, up. Cross step. Circle up. And if you can, speed it up. Just 5 more exercises. Then you're done. So circle up. Make sure that arm is slightly bent. Knees are slightly bent and that upper body is straight up. That's it. Come on. Left up, right up, cross behind. Up. Shoulders stay above the hips. Finding your balance. Using your core. That's it. 10 more seconds. Circle up. Left, right, final ones. Up. And that's it. Okay, over to that side lunge with that row, front right, side to side. So upper body straight up and go. So stepping out, make that row up. That's it. Make sure you lower that butt down so you don't bend over because then you're making a deadlift. And we want to work the quads, the glutes, the thighs here. So make sure that butt is lowering down. You row the weights up on chest height. Elbows to the outside. That's it. Come on, side to side, 20 seconds. Step it out. Keeping the heart rate up. Work on that body tone. Up. Don't quit. Come on, keep on stepping and row. And row. Final 5 seconds. Up. One more. That's it. Lower the weights down. And we're going over to that swing. Bending over, making the swings. Feet on hip wide, knees slightly bent. And go. Alternating swings up, then bending over. Up, bending over. Make sure your back is straight. When you bend over, up. Knees are slightly bent. And make big moves. Really pressing the weights up. And behind you, up, working the backside of the shoulders, upper back, lower back, come on, up, keep on swinging with power in those arms, up and down and up, 10 more seconds, come on, bend over, come up, bend over, come up, 5 seconds, keep on swinging, working your back, final ones, and that's it. Just two more exercises and then cool down already. We're starting with that lunge and press. So come on, curl and press. Curl and press. Up. Working biceps, shoulders, quads and glutes while keeping that heart rate up. Make sure when you curl, upper arms are still, elbows are still. Focus on your biceps. That's it. Press it out. Come on. Lower that knee to right above the floor if you can. Deep lunges, working quads and glutes. Up. 15 seconds. Come on. Find that balance. Up. Steady. You've got this. Come on. Press it out. 5 seconds. Up. One more. Press. That's it. Okay, we finish with that reverse tap and rows. So make sure you hold the shoulders down low, chest up, weights up in front, and go. Come on, finish strong. Tap and row. Really bring that elbow to your waistline. Small ones. Up. And bring the shoulder blades together. Come on, speed up if you can. Bring that weight up on chest height in front of you after that row. Row. Come on. Pull that weight down, back. Up. Up. Row. Row. 20 seconds. Come on. Don't quit now. Keep on going. Weights up. Chest up. Shoulders down low. Row. Row. 10 seconds. Don't quit. Stay strong. Final 5. Up. And that's it. Now drop the weights. You don't need them anymore. It's time for the cool down. So don't stand still, but slow it down, really slow it down. Shake out your arms. Come on, slightly bend over and shake it out. Focus on re-catching your breath, releasing the tension out of the shoulders. Come on, take a deep breath in. And out. And another one. Come in and out. Come on, standing up. Just keep making the steps if you want. Otherwise, stand still and add some shoulder rolls. Up. Big ones. Nice and slow. Really pull your shoulders up. Bring the shoulder blades together. And then reverse. Back up to the front. That's it. Releasing the tension out of the shoulders. All those weights we had to hold up during that main workout. Come on. Final roll. And that's it. Time for do some stretches. Come into a little wide stand. Knees are slightly bent. And now we're going to bend over straight back. One hand is going on the floor. If you can, otherwise just stay up as high as you can or as low as you can. And then what we're going to do is twisting in. Following your hand up, twisting in that upper body, stretching up your spine, your abs, that upper body. So really twist in as far as you can, following that hand up, twist open, feel that stretch. And then go down, and of course, switching over to the other side, opening up. Twist that upper body in as far as you can. Feel that twist on your spine, that stretch. Follow your hand up. And then lower it down. Come up a little bit and just swing over from right to left. Want to release the tension. Knees are slightly bent and swing up. Swing up. So come up a little bit while keeping swinging, swinging. Swinging, and that's it. Okay, now interlace your fingers behind your back and then stretch out your arms, bringing your chest up and pull your arms down, back. Feeling that stretch on your chest, on the front side of your shoulders. So pull your arms back, chest up, and just enjoy that stretch. And really pump those arms up if you can, feeling that stretch. And release. And another one. Interlace your fingers. Stretch up. Bring the chest up. And try to lift your arms up behind your back. Feeling that stretch in the front side of your shoulders and your chest. So pull down. Bring the chest up. And really swing. Swing. Rotate your shoulders. Really time for that stretch. And now stretching up the lower part of your body. One step is front, one is back. Really press the heel down from your rear leg. Stretch out your legs. And then with a straight back and an upper body, we're going to bend over, bringing the chest as far to the knees as we can while keep pressing the rear heel down. Feel that stretch on your calf and your hamstring. Your rear calf, your front hamstring. Bring the chest closer to your leg if you can. Feeling that stretch. And then bend the knees. Come up. And we're doing that same stretch on the other side. Big step back. Make sure you feel that stretch on your calf. And then make your upper body long. Bending over. Bring the chest towards the knee. Feeling that stretch in the hamstrings and our rear calf. And just hold it a second. Bring the chest closer to the knee if you can. Feeling that stretch. Don't push it too hard. Just make sure you feel that stretch enough for a good recovery after this workout. Okay, bend the knees. Come on up. Shake it out. And now we're going to do one final stretch. And then we're done. Make sure your shoulders are down low. Pressing the arms down. Make your neck long. Left hand is pressing down, and then your right hand is grabbing your head and pull your head towards your right shoulder while pressing your left hand down. Feeling that stretch on your neck. And then slowly release, and then over to the other side. Press that right arm down, make your neck long, and then pull your head towards your left shoulder. So you can feel that stretch in your neck. Press that arm down. And release slowly. And we finish with a head roll. So chin is going to the chest. Move over to your right shoulder. Head is going back. Watching up towards the ceiling. Roll over to your left shoulder. Back to the chest. And then from your chest, back to your left shoulder. All the way back, watching towards the ceiling, over to your right side, back to your chest, and then up. And that's it. Applause for you. You finished this workout. Give yourself a well-deserved thumbs up. Never forget it. Be proud of yourself. You finished an amazing workout. If you have to leave, I wish you a great day. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day and, of course, the rest of the Revive Your Fitness program. For all the patrons, the workout schedule for next week is going to release in 1 hour, so make sure you check it out. And if there are any questions, shoot, I will see what is happening in the chat. Stay here to answer some questions if you have some. Let's see. Catch up later. That's all right. And they love it. Yay. I hope it was a great workout. And I see the comments. I think it was great. So let me know if there are any questions. I will stay here. Thank you, Aaron, to join us. I know it's early there at your time. So it's very good you joined us this morning. And Terry, once again, thank you. Thank you for joining once again during this live workout. So great to have you all here. So I think there are no questions. I see people are leaving. That's fine, of course. I wish you all a great, great day. And make sure to stay tuned for the upcoming workouts for next week. And of course, next Saturday, there will be a live workout, same time. And I guess it's a cardio kickboxing workout next week. I'm not sure, but I guess it is. So make sure you're ready again next week, same time for the live workout. Thank you and have a great, great day. Bye.